السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to Iqra Talent Show. Lovely show regarding the talents that the children of this Ummah, Allah has bestowed upon them with the talents. And today we have some great contestants. Alhamdulillah, they will show their talents, inshallah. Five different categories they are going to perform their talent. The categories are, number one is the qirat, and second is the nasheed, and the third story, and fourth is the speech, and final is the azan. In all these categories, and let's introduce you first, the judges to you, alhamdulillah. Judges we have today. First, we have Mufti Abdul Muntaqim Saab, and then we have Mufti Saleh Ahmed Saab, and then we have another judge with us, Ustad Saifur Rahman Saab. Alhamdulillah. And the contestant we have, contestants, Sarina Tamreen we have with us, and then we have Ishaq Rahman and Liana Kiani and Ayan Khan, and then we have Wafa Amin. Five great contestants, alhamdulillah, with these five different categories. And inshallah, without any delay, let's start. May I call upon to the stage Sarina Tamreen.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm going to recite Surah Muzammil from ayah number 1 to ayah number 15. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها المزمل قم الليل إلا قليلا نصفه أو انقص منه قليلا أو زد عليه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا إنا سنلقي عليك قولا ثقيلا إن ناشئة الليل هي أشد وطئا وأقوم قيلا إن لك في النهار سبحا طويلا واذكر اسم ربك وتبتل إليه تبتيلا رب المشرق والمغرب لا إله إلا هو فاتخذه وقيلا واصبر على ما يقولون واهجرهم هجرا جميلا إن لدينا وذرني والمكذبين أولي النعمة ومهلهم قليلا إن لدينا أنكالا وجحيما وطعاما ذا غصة وعذابا أليما يوم ترجف الأرض والجبال وكانت الجبال كثيبا مهيلا إنا أرسلنا إليكم رسولا شاهدا عليكم كما أرسلنا إلى فرعون رسولا صدق الله العظيم.
Jazakallah, beautiful recitation from Sarina Tamrin, Alhamdulillah for Sarina's comment. Mufti Abdul Muntaqim Saab.
MashaAllah, very good recitation. Allah Ta'ala accept her tilawa. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Ami shudu nader ke bolbo je memorizing aro strong hoar dorkar. Memorizing ta kichu weak aro confident aro ektu barate hobe kintu এরপরে হরুফের মখারেজের মধ্যে সামান্য একটু লিটল বিট উইকনেস ইন মখরাজ লিটল বিট তো আমি মনে করি ভেরি গুড রিসাইটার হতে পারবে সারিনা আল্লাহ তাআলা ওনাকে যেন কবুল করেন মানে প্র্যাকটিস লাগবে মোর প্র্যাকটিস শি নিড মোর প্র্যাকটিস আল্লাহ তাআলা যেন কবুল করেন সাহস আছে কিন্তু পুরোপুরি
মে আই কল আপন টু দ্য স্টেজ ইসহাক রহমান
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I will be performing the beautiful azan. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
جزاك الله خير إسحاق رحمن ما شاء الله beautiful أذان الحمد لله for إسحاق comment. May I draw your attention, Mufti Salih Ahmed Saw.
MashaAllah, Isaac Rahman, your azan is beautiful, wonderful. MashaAllah. Jazakumullah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept you. Jazakumullah khairan.
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. Respected viewers, you enjoying the program called Iqra Talent Show. We have some more contestants with us. Alhamdulillah, the next contestant with us today is Liana Kiani.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Liana Kiani and today I'll be telling you the story about the man who killed 100 people. Not only is it a story, but it's also a hadith by Sahih al-Bukhari. There once was a vicious and gruesome man who had heartlessly murdered 99 people. He later felt guilt and remorse. One day he came across a monk and explained his past life and how he wanted to repent and become a better man. He asked the monk, "Will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me?" The monk was shocked on hearing the news and negatively replied, "No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could never forgive you." And then the man said, "Well, I may as well kill you too." So he did. The bloodthirsty man had now killed 100 people. Later on that day, he came across a worthy, knowledgeable individual and asked the individual, "Will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me for killing 100 people if I repent?" Being a wise man, he replied, "Of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you if you repent. I have one piece of advice for you. Leave this city where you're accompanied by wicked people and go to a city where you mix with good people, because bad company leads one into sin." He wept and sobbed and asked Allah for forgiveness and left the wicked city and went to find the righteous people. On his way, sudden death hit him and he died. And both angels of mercy and angels of punishment came to take his soul. They argued over who should take him. The angels of punishment said, "Well, he had killed 100 people and was a very sinful man, so we should take him." But the angels of mercy said, "Well, he repented to Allah and wanted to become a better man, so we should take him." They argued. So later, Jibreel alayhi salam was sent down to resolve the matter. Both angels explained what had happened and he said, "I will measure the ground. If he's closer to the bad city, then the angels of punishment will take him. But if he is closer to the good city, then the angels of mercy will take him." Because he just left the bad city, he was closer to the bad city. But because he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah made him outside the good country. Repentance is the most noble and beloved form of obedience in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah loves those who repent. Repentance is the highest form of worship. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves when a servant repents. In the Quran it says, "For those who repent, all your sins will be changed to good deeds." And certainly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ghafur, all-forgiving and all-merciful. Jazakallah.
MashaAllah, wonderful story. Alhamdulillah, thoroughly we were enjoying, MashaAllah. Ustad Saifur Rahman, over to you.
MashaAllah, well done, Liana. So that's a good moral story. Alhamdulillah, is really good. Well done. Feedback in terms, inshallah, in future when you do, just slow it down a little bit more so can people understand better. Inshallah, well done. Jazakumullah khair.
Jazakallah khair, Ustad. Alhamdulillah. You see our little stars, how they are performing. You must be happy. And we thank everybody that you are bringing your children up in Islamic way. And the stories they are saying, I'm so amazed. They are saying the stories from the book of Hadith. They're not making up anything, Alhamdulillah. So thanks to the Ustaz and the parents, of course. Next, we have another contestant with us, Muhammad Ayan Khan. Muhammad Ayan Khan.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها.
Jazakallah khair, Ayan. Stay there, inshallah. Let's hear comment about you from Mufti Abdul Muntaqim sir.
Inshallah, Ayan Khan, very good, inshallah, ta'ala, recitation here. But I think you need more practice. Some letters, all recitation are good. but in 1 and 2 point is mistake, some 1 and 2 letters only. Makhraj thik hoy ni, dui tinta jagay. To amader jonno ekhon faisala korte khub koshto hoy. Ar confidence aro badhate hobe. Confidence aro beshi korte hobe. Thik ache? Inshallah taala.
Jazakallah khair, Mufti sahab. Alhamdulillah, Ayan. It was wonderful, inshallah. So what Mufti sahab said, you need to be more confident. And in terms of your makharij, you need to take care of your makharij, how you pronounce the word and how you pronounce the letters. And along with your full mouth, empty mouth letters, you need to look after. Inshallah. Jazakallah khair, Ayan. Alhamdulillah. We have another contestant with us today. Wafa Anis. Wafa Anis, would you come to the stage?
Ramadan is a time when Muslims around the world fast, abstaining food and water in order to purify the body and soul. It is a special month because, as the Prophet has said, when Ramadan enters, the gates of hellfire are closed and the gates of Jannah are opened and the devils are chained. Thus, Muslims can create connections to the Prophet, devotion to Allah, and tie the community together without the influence of jinns. During the 30 days of fast, our body receives physical and mental improvement. We do nafil prayer and try to watch less TV and play less video games. We do more charity than the usual time amounts and times of the year.
Jazakallah khair. Wonderful, alhamdulillah. Wafa, you stay here. Let's hear from Mufti Saleh Musab the comment about Wafa.
Okay, Wafa Anis, jazakumullah khairan for coming here. A beautiful story. Jazakumullah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept you. You need to more confidence as well, yeah? Jazakumullah khairan.
Alhamdulillah. Jazakallah khair, Mufti sahab. Jazakallah Wafa Anis, alhamdulillah, respected viewers. Look, the children are the future of this nation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed this ummah. As the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beautifully said, وَشَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ. On the day of judgment, some people will be under the shade of Allah. One of those are those youth, those young children who spend their youth in the worship of Allah. This is what these children are doing at the moment. And you, as a parent, you are sacrificing your time, you are sacrificing your wealth, everything for these children. And so we make sincere dua that alhamdulillah, one of the day, these children will be brightest stars and they will lead this world, inshallah. And in today's episode, these five contestants, they perform in front of you. We will reveal exactly who is going to the next stage. So inshallah, once the result will be ready, we will let you know who is going to the next, inshallah. Iqra Bangla, all the time, take care of the Muslims, look after the people around the world, and this program, the Talent Show, was sponsored by Jamiatul Khair Al-Islamiyya, and then Jamia Madaniya Bishanat and Madinatul Khair Al-Islamiyya. These three our sponsors, alhamdulillah, they also spreading the work of da'wah around the world, around Bangladesh and elsewhere. So, alhamdulillah, as soon as our result will be ready, we will let you know who is going to next episode. So may I call upon to the stage all five of you. Come and line up, inshallah. How are you feeling, every one of you? Great. It was nice that you came, you performed. It is not easy thing to perform in so much big sheikh, and the entire nation is watching you. Alhamdulillah. But every one of you performed wonderful, mashallah. All judges are happy with your performance. But one of you have to go to the next round. So the next round, the contestant will be in. This is Sarina Tamreen. Jazakallah khair, Sarina Tamreen. We will see you next round and other contestants, your show and Sia, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.